Imagine this, a day filled with indulgence, bursting with excitement, and packed with extraordinary moments that build memories to last a lifetime. A day that is unmistakably yours, at the place that is undeniably spectacular. Whether you're winning big, dining lavishly, or relaxing oh so comfortably, it's your getaway reimagined at Soaring Eagle Casino and Resort.
Facebook page to learn more.
I can do this.
We believe in.
Each day brings hope.
Every day, millions of people celebrate their recovery from addiction and mental illness while others begin their journey. Be a part of it. Tell your story. Join the Voices for Recovery. Together, we are stronger. For 24-hour free and confidential information and treatment referral for mental or substance use disorders for you or someone you know, call 1-800-662-HELP.
Hey, Coach Prime. I think you've got what it takes to wear the Aflac.
Style, charisma, and a smile is 21 out of 10.
Aflac. You know Aflac can help keep unexpected health care costs from ruining someone's finances. Check out this coverage.
Still got Aflac. It, Coach. You still got it.
Aflac. I've never lost it.
Yeah. You see that coverage? With that wingspan, I see why you got more rings than a cell phone.
There's always room for one more.
Yeah.
Get help with expenses health insurance doesn't cover at Aflac.com.
You've been around long enough to know good stuff when you hear it. That's why you're here now. Classic hits. WQEE 99.1 FM, The Key.
Welcome to Connecting Hearts. Connecting hearts of women to resources, information, and to one another. Presented by Creative Heart Studios, 18 Perry Street and Noonan. Now here's your host, Marjorie Conway.
Hi, everybody. It's a good Thursday. It's a little sprinkling out there, but we're glad to be here and join with you one more time to talk to one of our friends and let you know some things about what's going on around here for our women and what the Connecting Hearts Network is doing. Over the last week, I have met with a couple of people individually, and those 30-minute talks, of course, that we had ended up being hours long because the women in this network, we are just meshing so well together and coming up with ideas that it's very exciting. So as we progress along through it, you're going to see more notifications coming up on your Facebook and more sharing and more things. But the anchor of it is this broadcast that we're passing out, and we're having our guests come in every week so that we can give you resources and inspiration and, you know, just a little bit of something to make your heart a little more joyful, a little more peaceful. And today we're bringing in the joy. We have Sassy Cindy. This is Cindy Ingle Sterling. She runs a jewelry business going around Noonan, and she is in our network because she brings the fun and the sparkle and just what extra we need, because sometimes some of the things that we will deal with are a little hard. You know, it's tough to be talking about women who's been in abuse and, you know, neglected children and health problems and all this stuff. So sometimes we got to let loose, and we've got to just let that sparkle inside come out. So this is Cindy. I want her to tell you a little bit about how she got into her business and what she does.
Okay. Well, happy Friday.
Thursday.
Eve. Friday Eve, baby, right?
Yeah.
So, I am Cindy Sterling, also known as
Sassy Cindy.
That's right. I love sassing ladies up and just giving them that confidence and fun that we all need, right?
That's it. I know when I started this broadcast, and I have mentioned online and to several other people, last December, I never thought I'd be somebody talking on the radio and actually enjoying it. I mean, it's energizing me. I'm ready to come in here and go out. But every week when I come in, I have my makeup done. Even though Ryan might think it's not much makeup, but for me, it's a lot. I comb my hair more than once, which sometimes don't happen. And I have on my jewelry because it just gives me a little bit more confidence. It makes me feel like, okay, I'm presentable. I can go out and face the world and talk. Now, I don't hide behind any of that because that's just the outward coverings. I know that that is just giving me a little bit of oomph so I can let what's inside come out. And I know Cindy does that. She has told me some stories about some women that she's been able to serve. And Cindy uses her business as a service business. She will tell you that her business is not about the jewelry. It's about emotions. So tell us about that, Cindy. How does that work?
Well, first of all, I just want to give y'all a vision of what Margie is looking like this morning.
Margie's rolling her eyes.
She is totally rocking her patina and multi-metal necklace sets. She's got a shorter one on. It's teardropped. It's got patina and copper and brass teardrops. And then she's got a longer necklace with turquoise and some crystals and brass. And she's got browns and turquoise and all natural tones on, and she is really rocking her look.
Well, and I tell you, if you stop by the studio down on Perry Street later, I'm going to be having on a plain green shirt and some brown leggings, because that's my comfort zone. I don't need to boost out the confidence down there. But Cindy, you're awful sparkly today, and you have mentioned to me in some of the talks that we've had of some people who have come to you and said, you know, I just really didn't feel beautiful or didn't feel that I had anything going on until then, this happened, until I put the jewelry on and stepped out there. So tell us a little bit about those conversations.
Well, I always grew up with a love of accessories. I got that from my mom. We both love jewelry. Mm-hmm. And so it's kind of a long story how I got into this business, but I got into this business just as a business, and God had mm-hmm. other plans, because my business quickly turned into a ministry, which I never thought would happen. I didn't even know anything about Facebook. I barely had a Facebook page. Mm-hmm. I didn't know anything, how I was going to work my business, but it's just evolved. And through all the steps I've been through with my business, I came to realize how many women, first of all, did not feel confident.
Yeah.
Did not have anyone say, you know what, girl, you are rocking it today.
Right.
Or you are beautiful. Or how many women didn't know how to accessorize and really were afraid to accessorize.
That's true.
How many women thought that they had to spend a gob of mm-hmm. money to accessorize, and that they could wear, they could be stay-at-home moms. You know, I was a stay-at-home mom. And I have a t-shirt and jeans on. Mm-hmm. But if you have a cute pair of earrings on or a cute ring or a bracelet, you know, you feel good. You feel together. So I just, my eyes were opened
right.
to a lot. And I started thinking out of the box. I've always been kind of an out of the box thinker. I think everybody who knows me knows that.
Absolutely. I can promise you that.
I like to have fun. And so I started using my business for fundraising.
Right. And she means fun, F-U-N, and fund, F-U-N-D.
Right. Because you can have fun, and people can get great jewelry while helping somebody else out.
That's it. And you know, Cindy uses her business as a ministry in many ways. I've talked to her about times that she's been in the grocery store line, and she has a super compassionate heart. And I can tell you, if she did a spiritual gifts test, Encourager would be one of her gifts. And she encourages me a lot, and has since we started this network. On the post, she's the one that you go, girl, and puts the likes and puts the, you know, little hearts and the animals down the bottom. And if you go check out all our posts, and even in our private group, Cindy is the number one poster and the number one liker. She is going to do what she can to build people up and to encourage them. She talks to them in the grocery store line, and if they say, oh, I love that necklace and I wished I had one, she will take it off her neck and let them have it. But she also goes into nursing homes. Tell us how you do what you do at the nursing homes.
Well, I play this game I kind of came up with, and not just assisted living or independent living type facilities, but really a fun ladies' night. Mm-hmm. I even have them at my clubhouse, and everybody has a great time, and I call it Blingo Bingo.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just like bingo, except you win jewelry.
Yeah.
And I mean, I don't know about the other ladies that are listening to this, but for me, I just don't like to think a lot. When I'm out having a good time, I want to put my brain on pause. I don't want to have to think about, you know, hard questions and, you know, try to, no, bingo, you call out a number, you block the number down, easy peasy, right?
That's
so
it.
It makes it fun, and you can do that as a fundraiser, or you can just have a fun ladies' night, and ladies walk away having a great girls' night, which, oh my gosh, how important is that?
That is, we need our circle of women to encourage us and support us. So we want them through the happy times and the sad times. And where she's talking about she wants to get out and not think, just have the numbers, I'm the one that wants to run the educational program and everybody come have fun with me while we learn this. And I have found out not everybody wants to learn this. But everybody does want to go knock the numbers out on the bingo card and win. And I've seen pictures that has been posted when, especially in the assisted living, you know, that they sometimes sit there all day, and some of them have no visitors. They don't have too many bright spots. And here comes Cindy with all of her jewelry and her bling and her happy attitude. And she has them all smiling by the time she leaves.
Well, they definitely think I'm crazy. But one thing the ladies love is I have a crown. And when you win that round of bingo, I put the crown on them and I take their picture. And
wow,
they look and feel like a queen. Now, it might only be for that round till the next lady wins,
right?
But I take their picture and I always send it to the activities director, and they can put it in their magazine or newsletter. And you know, sometimes it's just something simple like that,
right? And it doesn't take much. I mean, we go through our day, and a lot of times, and I have been as guilty of this than anybody else, we go through our day and we've got our blinders on and we're taking care of our to-do list and we're checking our things off and getting done what we got to get done. And, you know, we just don't feel like talking to anybody or anything. But like we point out a lot on here, we don't know what other people are going through. All of us are so good at putting those masks on, we don't know. And you know, you can do that with your jewelry and your makeup and do, I got it all together, when inside you're not. But that's one reason it's important for us to communicate and to have our circle of women around us so that they can see through the facade and know, okay, I need to give them some hugs and some pats on the back and a listening ear. But when we look better, when we feel better and we see that sparkle, you say it might just be for a few minutes for those residents, but I guarantee you that carries them through their week, because you know, sometimes they don't have much to look forward to, and mm-hmm, that is a big deal.
Well, and it's not only older women.
Yeah,
it's all women.
True.
And you were talking about on social media, it is so huge when people can comment something positive, or I see you, or I'm praying for
right.
you, or you know what, you're not alone in what you're going through.
Absolutely.
So just take 30 seconds and comment on a post.
Right.
That is so huge to people, and a lot of people don't do it. They just keep on scrolling. But I do believe it does make a huge difference. And you know, show yourself, share your fun self, you know.
Yeah.
I'm not known for being Sassy Cindy for no reason.
I knew of Cindy a long time before I knew Cindy. Some mutual friends of ours would post pictures and everywhere, and I was like, oh, they look like they're having so much fun. But you know, I am the introvert, and I have stayed home and not gone to all their fun activities, but I do recommend that other people do. And with Cindy, it's always joyful. I don't ever see anybody sad around Cindy. It doesn't
last. Sweet.
I mean, she comes in to talk to me, and we'll have a serious conversation, but before that's over, we're laughing our heads off. I mean, it takes just that much interest in somebody and just that much caring about people to cheer them up and keep them going.
Right. And, you know, everybody, I mean, you can look at people on Facebook and, you know, nobody's going to post. Well,
yeah.
I should say nobody. Some people do post pictures of them crying or whatever.
Mm.
But, you know, we all have stuff.
Right.
And you just got to keep pushing and keep
right.
knowing that you are not alone.
Right.
And, you know, you can seek outside help, but you also have to seek help from the inside.
Absolutely.
And one way I do believe is through accessorizing. You know,
yeah.
get up, get a shower.
And that's it. We've had COVID going on for what, 10 years now? Or is it just, feels like 10, but it's only been two, I guess. And then Noonan had their tornado, and so much stuff's going on. And I promise you, I stopped dyeing my hair before COVID because I was trying to go more natural and healthy, and I couldn't see the sense of keep putting that on my hair when God was winning. So I decided to do that, and now I'm trying to figure out how to get color around my face, and I found out I couldn't put the earrings I got from Cindy on because the holes had grown up, so I'm going to have to go do something about that. But I got to the point, I told somebody, I said, before this COVID is over and we're allowed to get out of the house and socialize again, I'm going to be without hair color, I'm going to drop the makeup, I'm only going to be in leggings and sweatshirts. That's it. I'll comb my hair for you. That's probably it. That's not true, because when I did start getting out, I needed to get out, because after the foot, I mean, COVID settled down, and then I broke my foot and I was sitting up for ages, and I had to get out a little bit. And just like I put on this jewelry and this makeup to come in here, I had to be more presentable when you go out to people. And, you know, COVID has depressed so many people. We've been stuck inside so much that it's just ridiculous. We need to get out and see how people are doing. I mean, on the blog post, the first blog post, I was reach out and touch somebody. And now I was, oh, no, not really, because they might have COVID. But you can give them a kind word and say, I'm here for you and I'm listening for you. Because, and also during COVID, domestic violence and abuse skyrocketed. I mean, people are in there, they're stressed, they're losing their jobs, they're stuck in the house with each other. And even if it wasn't domestic violence and things, divorce skyrocketed because the people who were stuck in the house together found out they didn't have anything else in common and they couldn't do things together. So it is very important that we be able to know the beauty inside and bring it outside.
Well, and you brought up a good point, because the whole COVID thing and people were shut in, and a lot of people were like, well, I don't need to wear jewelry mm-hmm. because I'm not going anywhere. Well, you're wrong.
Right.
Because even when you're home, I mean, you walk by a mirror at some point.
Not if I can help it.
Well, at some point, I mean, you know, if you feel like you're rocking it, then you will rock your day.
Well, and you know, people do take you by your looks. The first thing they do is they see you. And if they see somebody who is ragtag and not dressed well, they're not going to come to you for advice or for anything
Absolutely.
Else. They want somebody that looks like they're put together and know what they're doing. That's why I actually have somebody going to show me how to do makeup. Because back when I was 12, I wanted to wear makeup. My grandma said no. My grandma was the main influence when I was growing up. And she was, you know, only beautiful women wear makeup. Well, on my 13th birthday, she took me to a cosmetologist and bought me a huge bag of makeup. And I'm like, oh no, I must be really ugly.
Oh.
So I tried not to do that with my daughter. And I did do limited makeup and limited jewelry and limited things till somebody at one point said that I would look, you know, more Amish in my appearance, long hair and long skirts and things like that. And I'm like, well, maybe I need to. There's nothing wrong with that, but maybe I need to jazz it up just a little bit. And so it's been a journey. Cindy's teaching me to accessorize and throwing all this wonderful jewelry up on Facebook. And my husband says, you're not looking at Cindy's feet again, are you? And I was, oh, no, dear. And
oh, you're not alone in that one. You're not alone in that one. But I do want to bring up one thing. Hey, ladies, we do have a code word for today. And the code word is bling. So everyone that messages myself or Margie or even puts it on
Connecting Hearts, sends them a message.
On Facebook.
Right.
Their name is going to go into a drawing for a free piece of jewelry. Can I hear it for free?
That's
yeah,
good
baby.
Idea. I like free.
Yeah. Who doesn't like free, right?
I like free.
And that is one thing that is so fun, too, in my business, because it's my business. I can do whatever I want with it. And every Facebook party I have Facebook Messenger parties where I just post pictures really quickly and people just type sold on the numbers. And then I do have Facebook live parties you know, you can see. And it's, you know, different things for different people. Some people don't have time to sit through a live. And so they just see the pictures, but then you do lose something, because when I show them live and I show how you can wear mm-hmm. this piece of jewelry and you can actually see the sparkle when I hold it up to the camera or my phone or whatever device, So my Facebook group is called Sassy Tastic Accessories.
We'll put a link on the bottom of all these too so you can get to them.
And I always play fun games. Some you do have to think about, honestly. Some you don't, but I always give free jewelry away. So, you know, when I hear these people or somebody will comment on a piece of jewelry I have on my Facebook group and they're like, man, I wish I could get that, even though it might be $5, you know.
She always posts the ones I want when I'm not watching.
You know, I'll say, they're like, well, I can't afford that. And I'm like, but, you know what? You could win free jewelry.
Right.
You could add people to my group. You know, you could play a game and win the free piece of jewelry.
That's
so
true.
You know, it's not always about spend. And my jewelry is, my tagline is boutique jewelry at real chick prices.
That's it. And it is good prices. You know, I say my husband's going to kill me, but not as much as if I went to K Jewelers or something like that. I didn't go to Jared. I went to Cindy. And so it's
right,
much more affordable and just as pretty. Okay, Cindy, we have a few more minutes here. And I want to touch on something that we've talked about recently. And we don't have to mention names of companies or anything, but you mentioned to me, and this is much in my heart with our network, as a Christian businesswoman, you parted from a company that was not having practices the way that you felt they should and started
exactly.
your own. So tell me a little bit about that process and how you decided I have to cut my line and say, here's my boundary and I'm going to step out.
Well, after it became known and it wasn't a gossipy thing, it was black and white, real information that this company had lied about their product and what was in their product and what was not in their product, and saying that their styles were their own styles and they weren't, and a lot of other things that I knew I couldn't be a part of that anymore. And I'd been with that company for 6 years.
Mm-hmm.
And I really believe, you know, if you don't do right, it's
right.
all going to come out. I wanted to distance myself from that company as fast as I could. And I had a team of 387 people.
And a lot of people would have a hard time walking away from that.
But, you know, at the end of the day, it's my reputation.
Right.
You know, I am what I share. And I say share because I don't think I sell anything. I share jewelry. I share
right.
ideas. You know, so at the end of the day, people associate what I do or what I share with my reputation.
Right.
I mean, people buy from people they know, like, and trust.
Absolutely.
And I would say 99% of my customers, and they are all over the country. Almost every state I have customers. We're friends.
Yeah.
And I couldn't treat a friend like that. I couldn't
right.
lie to a friend or share a product with a friend that
right.
I knew was not what it said it was.
And that's good. That is something that you need to be proud of. And it's along the lines with that, as you stepped out and made your own company, and as you did that, God's blessed it. I've watched it. You are really doing well, and it hasn't been that long since this happened, but God is really blessing.
He really
yeah.
is. I'm telling you, I am hopping. And the thing I love about it the most is that I can get inspirational
right.
pieces.
Right.
That the company I was with before did not provide because it wasn't a Christian-based company.
Right.
And people are loving these because I've seen a lot of the pieces that I have in some of the boutiques. And
mm-hmm.
they're selling $35, $40, where I'm selling them for $5.
Right.
At most $10.
Right.
So...
Yeah.
God is really blessing me, and I really feel like He's blessing the ladies that can get these pieces?
Oh, absolutely. It's a good witness to be able to have. I have one of my bracelets on now, and I'm always wearing my crosses or something there. And the fact that you can get that jewelry at this point is making me buy more jewelry from you.
And it's trendy. Yeah. We're not talking about, you know, old, yucky, you know, your grandma kind of jewelry. No, it's fun and it's trendy.
Yeah.
And you can stay on trend without having to change your wardrobe. I mean, I literally have a white, plain white shirt on. Mm-hmm. But today I have fun iridescent earrings on. And iridescent is really, really, really hot right now.
Right.
That's all you got to do. And I have an iridescent ring on.
And she tried to talk Ryan into hanging a bunch of the iridescent lights and maybe a disco ball up here in the radio station. So that way, when you're riding down Main Street, you would know where it was.
Right, you'll say, I want to go where that party is.
Yeah. Her first things was, can you put like girls want to have fun behind us when we're talking? Because we just want to have fun. And that is very important. You know, it's in everything that we have in life. We need some downtime. We need to have business women that we can trust to do the right things, even when it makes it difficult for a little while. We need to have confidence to come out of our shells and to, you know, just know that you are beautiful. Because, you know, the Bible does say don't go for vainglory, but the Bible also tells you that, you know, your beauty is on the inside and it needs to come out. And sometimes you just need a boost and a little bit of help doing that. And so Cindy can definitely help you do that. So Cindy, what are you doing on March the 8th? It's like the second Tuesday in March.
Oh, I don't know. I would have to look at my calendar.
If your calendar's free, maybe we ought to have a blingo at Happy Life.
Okay.
All right. We'll put notes about that up. She'll check her calendar. I checked mine. I'm free that night, and I already have Happy Life reserved for the second Tuesday in the month.
Let me tell you, ladies, it is fun. I mean, bingo has come a long way. You think of bingo. Okay, really, let's be real.
Yeah.
You think a bunch of old people barely able to move.
Oh, and my grandma took me forever and would have 20 cards out, and all the people smoked cigarettes.
This is not that kind of bingo. This is blingo bingo, and we raise the roof. We get fun music going, and it's awesome. So
watch for our on all our social media and everything and see if we're going to be able to do Blingo Bingo on March the 8th. Cindy, I thank you for coming and talking to me today.
Thank you for having me.
And in our network, she is the sassy sparkle that we need to pump us up some. So you're going to be seeing her out and about and things going on with the network. And we are happy to be able to come and do this. And we're building up social media and the women are getting together and making plans. So we look forward to working with you as things go. And as normal, if you're looking for me, you know, I'm all over Facebook and all over social media as Live Loved CHT for the Creative Heart Studio. As far as finding me in particular, you can walk up and down Perry Street and open the doors up and yell, Margie, and eventually I'll come out. And so I was thinking about putting a sign outside that says Margie's Inside, but that's not as fun as you opening the doors and everybody wondering where I'm at. So just walk on down to Perry Street on the corner to make it easy for you, and you yell Margie, and that has actually been happening lately. And I'm like, I'm back here in the corner. Come see me.
Stay sassy, everybody.
Absolutely.
Thanks for tuning in to Connecting Hearts with Marjorie Conway. Connecting hearts of women to resources, information, and to one another. Presented by Creative Heart Studios, 18 Perry Street, here in Noonan. 404-528-8461. Until next time, have a wonderful day.
Gorgeous gaming, stunning streams, unbelievable bandwidth. It's another Lifestyles of Gagillionaires. Meet the AT&T Fiber customers winning at life with hyper gig speeds. Meet Gagillionaire Terry. While his love of streaming horror movies has him constantly on the edge of his seat, his internet bill won't give him a scare.
Oh, don't go in there. I'm telling you.
Because since Terry upgraded to AT&T Fiber with hyper gig speeds, he doesn't worry about data caps or equipment fees.
Come on, man. The door's open for a reason.
And best yet, he also doesn't stress about a price increase at 12 months, because with the amazing Gagillionaire lifestyle comes an exquisite sense of tranquility. Most of the time. Live like a Gagillionaire. Get straightforward pricing with AT&T Fiber, internet that upgrades everything. No data caps, no equipment fees, and no price increase at 12 months.
Limited availability in select areas. Visit att.com/hypergig for details.
This President's Day, celebrate American legends with great deals at the Jeep President's Day event. Right now, get 0% financing for 72 months on select 2021 Jeep Grand Cherokee models. Excludes Grand Cherokee L, SRT, and Trackhawk. 0% APR financing for 72 months equals $1,389 per month per 1,000 finance for well-qualified buyers through Chrysler Capital, regardless of down payment. Not all buyers will qualify. See dealer for details. Take retail delivery from dealer stock by 2/28/2022. Jeep is a registered trademark of FCA US LLC.